Oh, hey there. Inconsistent Uploader here. Back at it again with the inconsistent setup. You know those movies and cartoons from your childhood that you vaguely remember watching and you may have been thinking at the time, oh my goodness, this is amazing. I love this cartoon series so much. I want all the action figures. I want all the merchandise. I want everything. This series is awesome. I wish these characters were real. But then you get older and you come across it again somehow and you watch it again. And then you think to yourself, how did I ever enjoy this? You know, the what feeling. Well, make no mistake, while there are certainly some pieces of media out there that definitely make me cringe and really regret my childhood choices, this movie is not one of them. The movie I'm about to mention puts me roughly in the middle. It's not early 2000s, poorly aged, baby-faced Planes level of bad, but it's still random, crazy, and likely a xenophiliac's wet dream. Kind of like my second channel. The movie I'm talking about in question is Chicken Little. Even the DVD cover is random. Like, what is even going on here? The movie starts out with Chicken Little ringing the city bell to let everybody know that they're in danger. Panic ensues and all hell breaks loose. Cars crash into things. Things are falling apart. Fire trucks are sent out. It's looking like the rapture is upon them until...
Chicken Little! What is it? What's going on?
One of the animals asks Chicken Little about what's happening.
The sky is falling!
Of course, no one believes him, and he becomes the laughingstock of the town. This also affects him at school, where nearly every kid bullies him because they're scumbags, and the kids that don't bully him are also socially awkward themselves. Abby is a duck with a speech impediment, and Runt is a pig whose only two attributes are that he's fat and somewhat dumb. To make matters worse, adults don't take Chicken Little seriously either, not even his own dad. One thing you're gonna notice about Chicken Little's dad is that he is not really a good parent at all. He's terrible, actually. In hopes of redeeming himself, he contemplates joining the baseball team. His father, being the wonderful guy he is, tries to talk Chicken Little out of joining. But he does it anyway, wins a game, and people finally seem to respect him when... the sky falls! Who would've thought? Once he finds the piece of the sky, he invites Abby, Fish, and Runt over to show them what he found. Fish ends up flying to the spaceship using the hexagon platform and everyone else follows suit. Once there, not only do they come across this small candy corn looking thing, they also find out that there are indeed aliens on the planet and that they are going to take over Earth. Once they start leaving, they get ambushed by the aliens. They run to the bell tower but it's locked, so Chicken Little gets creative and uses a soda bottle as a jetpack, which is the same technique he used earlier to get inside his school. This makes me want a Mario game where Mario uses soda as a jetpack. Make it happen, Nintendo! Make it happen! He gets to the bell, rings it, and lets everyone know that there are aliens. He tries to show them, but because Chicken Little has the worst look on the planet, the spaceship pulls a Phineas and Ferb and disappears before everyone else can see it.
Dad! I'm not making this up! You gotta believe me this time.
No, son. I don't.
You're just a little kid. That's why I'm going to side with random strangers instead of my own son. Seriously, I know I mentioned it briefly before, but Chicken Little's dad is such a prick. I understand alien invasions aren't exactly a believable thing to a lot of people, but he still could have at least tried to see his son's side of things instead of just siding with people he doesn't even know. Chicken Little sits outside his house with his friends trying to comfort him until the candy corn alien that he saw earlier in the ship finds him. The alien is named Kirby, and he explains to everyone that he needs to get back to the ship so he can go home. Not long after he says that, the aliens start invading with some music that, despite being about the end of the world, is still hilariously unfitting. Seriously, play this music over any disaster scene ever and you'll know what I'm talking about. They go into a movie theater where his dad finds him and Chicken Little finally calls him out on how bad of a dad he is. The only instance of character development in this movie and it went towards the character who needed it the most. Now if only the other characters could have had that also. Oh yeah, Chicken Little also does this.
By the way, I'd like to say I've always found you extremely attractive.
Classic Chicken Little, the only movie to have a father and son makeup and have a random kiss scene all in the middle of an alien invasion. Kirby sees the spaceship above the bell tower, and they race to the roof of the building so Chicken Little can show the aliens they have Kirby. They get vaporized and end up in limbo with everything else the aliens have vaporized so far, and Kirby's dad threatens to kill Chicken Little and his dad until Kirby explains the situation to him. Once the misunderstanding is cleared, everything is returned to normal, and his parents explain that they just came to Earth because they wanted some acorns. I'm not even kidding. Also, the dad has an alien Mickey Mouse watch. I am simply mentioning this because it will forever be humorous to me seeing derpy three-eyed Mickey Mouse on a watch and nobody can tell me otherwise. The aliens leave, and a movie about everything that transpired in the movie is made. So yeah, it's a movie within a movie.
Call me.
Gary! I was just looking for the sports channel, Gary.
To be honest, my feelings toward this movie are just so mixed. It's so random that there's honestly nothing really memorable about it. Chicken Little really doesn't have much going for it. Even when I think back to watching this movie as a kid, I still only remember Chicken Little being the character that was like, the sky is falling, the sky is falling! And that still applies to me now. Heck, I wasn't even sure if I was even gonna make a video on this because my initial responses were just kinda all over the place. Even though I took notes, it still didn't really help. I was still just wasn't sure what to really talk about at first. The movie felt kind of boring, honestly. I'd have to say I'm going to give this a solid 5 on the what scale. I could see how it would appeal to little kids because, ooh, cute little alien! Oh, cute little animals! Oh, cute little everything! Basically everything in this movie kind of looks cutesy, one way or the other. So I can see why kids would like this. Heck, I liked it! But it just doesn't really appeal to me now. Honestly, I'd rather rewatch the Alvin, the Chipmunks, and Smurf movies over this again. Yes, I did just say that, and I have no intention of apologizing. But that's just me. And at the end of the day, an opinion is just that. An opinion! Besides, if it wasn't for this movie, I wouldn't have my persona. If you enjoyed, subscribe, follow my socials, and remember to always stand Chick-fil-A and Popeye's chicken sandwiches. Toodles!